Hi, and welcome back. Now that you're learning to use Microsoft Teams, it might be time to learn a little something about blended learning and how we can deliver that inside of Teams. So we're going to talk about what a HyperDoc is, and I'm going to show you an example and how you can go find some that might work for you, and then in the case that they are a Google Doc, change them into a Microsoft Word doc. Or if they're a Google slide presentation, simply change them into a PowerPoint and use them to deliver blended learning experiences through Teams in your classroom. So let's get started. Let's take a look at our first HyperDoc. You can see here what I have is a Microsoft Word document that has an activity or an experience for kids. In this particular example, students are going to be looking at what they desire and creating their own individual manifestos as part of the process. It's really meant to be a writing assignment in which kids critically think about the things that matter to them. I am delivering this particular HyperDoc using Microsoft Teams tabs. And you can see that at the top where it has the manifesto HyperDoc. I've created the HyperDoc in Word, and I am highlighting it in my class using Teams tabs. Now, what makes a HyperDoc a blended learning lesson is that it is a document in which kids have a full learning experience, a full learning cycle. So in this one, they engage and explore with manifestos looking at different kinds, and they learn what a manifesto is, and then finally they apply that knowledge by creating their own manifesto. So this doc allows students to be really organized and to have a place where all work is located. And while students can maneuver through this at their own pace, it is not meant to be void of any teacher instruction. It still needs the teacher to really help students navigate the process, direct discussions, and help students unpack vocabulary and use words in a way that will help them craft a better writing response and manifesto at the end. This is an overview of a HyperDoc. To learn more, I recommend going to hyperdocs.co. If this blended learning lesson looked interesting to you, you can come here to hyperdocs.co and find out more. In fact, they have some free courses that help you get started understanding the HyperDoc process. You can also find examples and look through some that people have already created, from reading to math to elementary, and you can see some of the templates that people have used to make their own. So if I look at the basic HyperDoc lesson, which we were actually doing the Explore, Explain, Apply, that particular HyperDoc was made from this template, but it ended up looking like the one we just saw. So you're gonna wanna come to the site and look around. I recommend going to sign up because then you have access to those free courses. Now, if you find an example that you like in the samples, and let's head and see if we can find one for mathematics, you'll notice that they are all done in Google Docs, but that shouldn't stop you. Don't worry about that. Let's click on this one. And this is actually a choice PD board, which is a little bit different than an actual HyperDoc, because there is no Explore, Explain, Apply. But there'll be more on that when you take the course inside of hyperdocs.co. But if I want to make this a Microsoft Word document, all I need to do is go to File and Download as Microsoft Word. It will download it, and then I can upload it into my Office 365 account, and almost all of the formatting will be exactly the same, and I might have to make a few adjustments. So that's an easy way to find something that you like. But back here, you might find one that is a slides, and this one is slides, which means it's made in Google Slides. But again, all you have to do is go to File, Download as a PowerPoint, and now it's yours to use in PowerPoint. So up until now, it's mostly been people who are at Google Schools using HyperDocs. But times have changed, and now we can deliver these really great lessons by downloading them as a doc or a PowerPoint and uploading them into Teams.